Middletown, Pennsylvania, 5-4 in Fargo, North Dakota, to take the championship. Channel 5's Rob Lear was at last night's game, and we will have a full report on that for you at 6 o'clock. I can tell you this, they fell behind 4-0 and came back to win. It was an exciting game.
Ought to roll out the banners in Edina and have a parade for the hometown team.
Boy, they should. I'll tell you, that's a major accomplishment.
I understand on that team it was mostly made up of the kids that won the AA championship in high school.
Right? Plus kids who played on the Edina hockey teams, Edina football. I mean, just a lot of good athletes.
Just to win in your own league is hard at American Legion Baseball, let alone go on and win a national championship.
But Anderson, this is not the first time for a Minnesota team.
In 1943, Richfield did it, so this is the second time. 40 long years.
Ooh, about time.
The Edina American Legion Baseball team pulled off what I think is a great achievement last night, winning the national championship despite being short one of their stars. Dan Carroll could not get the University of Michigan to loosen their rules about attending freshman orientation. Carroll has a hockey scholarship to Michigan. This team certainly has what it takes to overcome adversity, as our Steve Carroll reports.
They defeated Boyertown in the opening round of this double elimination tournament, but no question about it, another victory over the defending champions from Pennsylvania would make an impossible dream come true for the Edina American Legion team. After a 40-minute rain delay, Edina's dreams quickly turned into a nightmare, as Boyertown erupted for 4 runs in the third inning, 2 coming in a triple to right. It stayed 4-0 Boyertown until the 8th, when Edina started to come alive. Pat Donahue's key single to right brought in the first 2 Edina runs, and before the inning was over, Edina had cut the lead to 4-3. Then, with 2 out in the 9th, and Edina still trailing by a run, Kyle Ramsey stepped up and hit what appeared to be the game's final out. But a violent collision in the outfield jarred the ball loose, and Edina's Paul Kimball wheeled around from first to tie the game at 4-4. Then, moments later, Pat Donahue came through in the clutch and delivered the game-winning hit to right, allowing Ramseth to score from second as Edina unbelievably had the lead of 5-4. But Boyertown had a final chance. They had runners at the corners with nobody out in the bottom of the 9th, but a couple of sparkling defensive plays and a big game-ending strikeout by Edina's ace Rob Wassenauer preserved the 5-4 victory as Edina pulled off one of the greatest comebacks of all time to capture their first American Legion World Series title.
Didn't come very easily, as you know. That's a big one for us, and of course, after 40 years, it's about time they came back to Minnesota.
It looked a little bleak for a while. I thought if we could just get a few men on early in an inning and put some pressure on them, you know, and then somebody could deliver a big hit, and we finally did get something going late in the 8th and 9th inning.
I'm on top of the world. I'm in cloud 9. I'm just shaking all over. I can't believe it. It's the most unreal thing that's ever happened to me.
It gives me great pleasure to present the championship trophy for the best team in America this year.
Reporting from Fargo, North Dakota, Steve Carroll, 11 Sports.
This American Legion baseball team can call themselves World Series champions. Last night in Fargo, Edina rallied from 4 runs down late in the game to knock off defending Legion champion Boyertown, Pennsylvania, 5-4. Channel 5's Rob Lear was at the game and has this report.
The early innings of last night's title game in Fargo featured two of the tournament's top pitchers, Edina hard-throwing right-hander Rob Wassenauer and Boyertown, Pennsylvania ace Darrell Shandley. For the first 3 innings, both pitchers were by far getting the better of the batters. Until the 4th, when the defending champions from Pottstown, PA collected 4 hits to score 4 runs.
We actually were throwing balls to their strength. He had a bad inning, and we paid for it.
The score stayed that way until the 8th, when Edina scored 3 runs, then tied it dramatically in the 9th with 2 outs, when Carl Ramses popped fly down the left field line, causes a collision. This play allows Paul Kimball to score all the way from first base, and the game was tied at 4. After an injury timeout, Pat Donahue followed with this sharp single to right that scored the winning run, and the celebration was on.
Championships are nothing new for the sports-minded community of Edina, but this is one the entire state can be proud of. It's been 40 years since a Minnesota amateur baseball team could lay claim to American Legion World Series champion. I'm Rob Lear, Channel 5 Eyewitness Sports.
As we discussed earlier tonight at 6 o'clock on 11 Sports, the Edina football team is in the midst of an unusual transition period. And now with more on that, here is Jeff Passel.
When the Edina American Legion baseball team won the American Legion World Series earlier this week, sports fans in our area were thrilled to see a local club achieve such prestigious success. But in their hometown, five of the players from that championship team found some disgruntled football teammates when they returned, because their baseball season had kept them from several grueling preseason football workouts.
Well, they were rather upset, and they were upset about the conditioning that we missed. And, well, they wanted me to work harder, and I think they got a good point. I mean, we are a little bit out of shape.
But. In the middle of the controversy was the mentor of the Edina High School football program, Coach Stav Kanakis, who found himself between a rock and a hard place.
You got to realize when you practice 3 weeks in 90-degree temperature, high humidity, someone then walks back in after that 3 weeks and takes your job, it's a little difficult to accept that situation.
As bad as things looked for the players in question, cooler heads eventually prevailed, and the vote was reversed.
It was kind of split in half. Half the guys thought that they worked so hard during the 2 days, and they wanted them off the team, but like some other guys, some of the seniors kind of said that, they've been playing with us all year and other years, and they should be on the team. And plus, they should be punished for winning a national championship. That's kind of a nice honor to win it, so I figure that they shouldn't be punished.
So what could have been a very sticky situation has apparently been resolved here at Edina High School.